गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन. इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी लर्न अबाउट फंडामेंटल्स ऑफ लैंग्वेज प्रोसेसिंग एंड ऑल्सो वी लर्न अबाउट नीड एंड कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ सिस्टम सॉफ्टवेयर. राइट, होप यू हैव वॉच्ड ऑल दोज वीडियोज. नाउ इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट सम इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट असेंबलर एंड ऑल्सो सम प्रोसेसिंग अबाउट असेंबली लैंग्वेज. सो लेट्स सी हाउ एग्जैक्टली इट विल बी वर्क. So following points are covered in this video. We generally use what is assembler, assembly language, their applications, elements, then assembly process, examples, and also design and working of assembler, data structures, pass one assembler, pass two assembler, and also some advantages and disadvantages of assembly language program. So let's see. So first, what is meant by assembler and assembly language? I already told you in my last session, the assembler. Assembler is a system software which generally used in assembly language program and translate your assembly language program into the machine language, right? Because assembly language program is understandable by the user, or this is your source code, right? So assembler convert this code into the machine language format. Machine language format means in binary language, the language which is understandable by the computer, and binary language always in the format of 010 format, right? So next, assembly language. Assembly language is kind of low level programming language. Generally we use C, C++, Java language. These all are the high level programming language, right? So low level programming language we uses symbolic codes, mnemonic instructions, etc. So these are the some examples like add, sub, LDA, STA. This kind of instructions are used in assembly language. Clear? Next. Now applications of assembly language. So assembly language generally or completely used in electronics field. Assembly language is used direct on hardware manipulation. It access specialized processor instruction, their address calculations of each and every instruction. So that is completely based on embedded system or hardware part. Okay, typically uses are devices like drivers, CD, hard disk, then some low level embedded systems like keyboard, then a water tank indicator, mouse, real time systems like computer, notepad. So all the hardware devices, assembly language programming will be used. Okay, so this is completely hardware or embedded system part. Next. So elements of assembly language. Mainly there are three types of elements as in assembly language, that is mnemonic operations code, symbolic operands, and data declaration. So first element in assembly language is mnemonic operation code. So what is meant by mnemonic operation codes? It generally used for the machine instructions, right? This all the mnemonic codes are easy to understand or easy to remember than numeric operation code. See in this example, the given example is opcode, instruction, and remark, right? So simply mnemonic operation code simply means the instruction, that is stop, add, sub, mult, multiplication, then move R, move M, division, read, print. These are all the examples of mnemonic operation code, right? So it's easy to remember as compared to numeric operation, right? So add, this instruction is easy to remember. So per add means 01, sub means 02. So this numeric instruction or numeric operation hard to remember, right? That's why we use mnemonic operation code. Next, symbolic operand. So symbolic operand is simply means symbols, names or variables that will be used in your program. So symbolic names with data or instruction use the particular symbolic names as operands in assembly statement. For example, add R1, R2, R3. So this R1, R2, R3, these operands are called as symbolic operands or the variables, right? Next, data declaration. Data can be declared in variety of notations, including the decimal notation. In assembly language program, you should declare a variety of notations of the particular elements. See here. Suppose you should declare num103, right? You should also declare this num103 in hexadecimal format also. That is 03 in hexadecimal notation, 0011H. Okay? So meaning of those declaration is same. So there are different variety of notation of this same element. Clear? So these three are one of major elements of assembly language. Now assembly process. So assembly process simply means to convert .asm file, that is assembly language file, into the .object file, that is machine understandable format. Okay, See, in this structure, that is assembly language program, that will be converted into the target program. Okay, in between that there will be a assembler. So this assembler has two paths, pass 1 and pass 2, and all this data of pass 1 and pass 2 are stored into the symbol table. Okay, so I will explain in detail in my next slide what is pass 1 assembler and pass 2 assembler. Okay, now there are some example of assembly language with assembler directives. Okay, so see, this is just one example of assembly language, here assembly program. Okay, so the first one is label, then opcode, operand, and location counter means addressed value. Okay, so label means any label, that is particular name. Okay, opcode means instruction, that is mnemonic code. Operand means value or registers, and location counter means address. The first instruction is start. Okay, so here start, then LTORG, then end, these are the directories that will be imported in your assembly language program. Okay, so first instruction is start 200. John is a name of the program. Okay, you should give any name to your program, and execution of program are start from the 200, that is location place. Okay, next move r, this is one of the mnemonic instruction. This indicates that move 3 into the register r1. Okay, so equal to 3, this is indicate that is constant. Equal to sign always indicate that is constant value. You should not change the value that will be stored into the register. Okay, so equal to 3 is a constant value. So this 3 value are stored into the r1, that is move r means move into register. Next instruction move amp means move into the memory. So x value, that is character value, that will be move into the register r1, that is move into memory. Okay, next instruction is l1 move r. So l1 is just one kind of label or any name of that particular instruction. Okay, so move r means stored this 2 value, constant value, into this r2 register. Okay, next LTORG. So LTORG is one kind of directories that will be used in assembly language program for imported all the library files regarding constants or literals. Okay, and next DS means data space, X is a label or any name to the particular instruction, and that is 1. So DS allocated 1 byte of memory to the X variable, that is character variable, it allocated 1 byte of memory. Okay, then finish, that is end means it finished the program execution, and that is address of each and every instruction or each and every line. Clear? So this is just simple example of assembly language program. I will explain in detail. Now next is design and working of assembler. So when assembler compile your source code and convert it into the target program, so at that time there are 2 phases will be performed. First analysis phase and another is synthesis phase. Analysis phase is called as pass 1 of assembler, and synthesis phase is called as pass 2 of assembler. Okay, so why we use analysis phase? Analysis phase is the first statement or first instruction that will be performed by the assembler. Okay, so analysis phase analyze complete source program and build symbol table for synthesis phase to proceed. It determines address of each symbol, which is called as memory allocation. It provide a memory for each and every symbols. It also hold the address or address of each and every instruction, right? It stored all the data, analyzing different operands, analyzing different constants, and also analyze different types of mnemonic instruction that will be properly allocated or properly assigned or not. Okay, analysis phase also check validate meaning and address of each statement. If anything will be wrong in that phase, then it generate the error or assembler generate the error. Otherwise, it execute the program and will display the output. Okay, the next phase is synthesis phase. Synthesis phase take a output of the analysis phase and also analyze completely once, and the build machine instructions of each and every line of the particular program. Okay, so complete analyzing code is converted into the machine instruction or machine understandable format. Okay, so let's see in detail structure of assembly language. Okay, so see, the first is symbol table. Symbol table store value or address assigned to the label. So assembler analyze all the label and their address of this program. Okay, and stored those label and address into the symbol table. See here, which is the label? John, that is your program name, L1 and X. These all labels are stored into this label part and their address of that particular instruction. That is John 200, L1 202 and X is 204. So this is your symbol table. Next, assembler analyze all the literal table, all literal or constants in your program and store into the literal table. That is minus equal to 3 and equal to 2. These are the constants or literal value. Okay, they has their own address. That is equal to 3 stored into the 200 location counter and equal to 2 stored into the 202 location counter, right? So in literal and address. And these are the index. Index always start with 0 and 1. I mean, there are two literals in your source code, right? Assembler again analyze operation code table or mnemonic operation code with their opcodes and length. See, in this program, opcodes or mnemonic operation codes are move R, move M and move R. These are the instructions. Okay, again there are some add, sum, division. These are also a mnemonic operation code. Okay, so in this program there are total three instructions, move R, M and move R. Okay, so assembler analyze those instructions, their opcode. Opcode means on which element or which operand this action will be performed. So move R perform equal to 3, move M perform on X and move R is performed on 2, constant variable, right? So these are the opcodes of that particular instruction. And this is a length bytes, means integer required 2 bytes, then character required 1 bytes of data in this way, okay? So assembler analyze all the instructions in your program and stored into the operation code table. So this is your complete symbol table or data structures in assembly language, right? So assembler analyze all those data and stored as per their data structure table, okay? This is your first pass, that is assembler analysis phase, okay? Assembler analyze all the data. Now next pass of assembler is pass to assembler, that is synthesis phase. So second pass of the instruction, that is synthesis phase. Synthesis phase read complete data that will be given by the analysis phase, okay? They again analyze those data and assemble using the symbol table. They analyze all the data structure, all the symbol tables in of your particular source code, okay? Then synthesis phase analyze those code and convert your complete block of program into the machine code or in machine language format, okay? Assembler proceed each and every instruction and convert it into the machine code. So sometimes it also work as an interpreter, right? So what exactly task performed by the synthesis phase? It convert mnemonic operation code, symbolic table operands into the machine language. It also converts some constants and also some internal machine representation into the machine language. So simply synthesis phase generate dot object file of your particular program, okay? So synthesis phase analyze, first analyze, then convert it into the machine understandable format, that is binary language or which is also called as object file. Clear? There are some advantages and disadvantages of assembly language program. The advantages, that is hardware oriented. It increases the readability by using data structure because they sort the data as per the requirements. Then also useful in embedded system, which required less resources managing the size and code. And also hardware driver system code is easily as compared to high level programming language. Okay, because high level programming language generally used for software purpose or different applications purpose, but assembly language generally used for hardware purpose. Okay. Now, what are the some disadvantages of this language? This is a machine dependent, right? Because it's completely generated different types of machines, drivers, hardware, that is machine dependent, okay? So next disadvantages is platform dependent, okay? Because each and every hardware or each and every system has their own specifications, right? So it is not necessary to same program can be implemented on another system, another hardware parts also, okay? So porting is not easy in assembly language. It's more difficult to debug because it's directly contact with hardware and more complex in nature as compared to high level programming languages. Okay, so these are the some advantages and disadvantages of assembly language program. Clear? Next. Hope so you understood the complete topics or overview of assembler and assembly language process. Keep practicing. Thank you.